father, he was late. And I think you know Harriet Williams, don't you?
Yes, I do.
You know Harriet?
Yes, I know Harriet.
Oh, here's your little book. Right. So what were you talking about before I came in?
Well, we were talking about the year that the school was built.
Oh, which year was that?
Well, we was trying to decide. And I think it was about 1914.
That far back.
And that's the second school in this area of improvements extended.
What was the first one you went
well,
to?
Well, the first school was up here on the hill also.
Oh.
But they tore that building down and built the new school.
Oh. Now, was the Richardson School a Roscommon school? People keep asking me that at the Gallimore House. Was that the first Roscommon school?
No, it was always the, first it was the
Richfield?
Maple Grove School. And then they called it the Richardson School.
Oh, why did they change the name?
Well, Uncle Frank Richardson, he donated the land up here for the school.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
And I wonder if we could shut that, maybe we don't get the...
And in time, why they changed it then to the Richardson School.
Oh, I see. Mm-hmm. Great. And when did you first go there then?
I started there in 1914 when I started school here. Mm-hmm. I was 5 years old when I started the school.
Was it all an ungraded school then?
All the grades, from first to eighth.
That's nice. So what else were you talking about besides the year for you?
Well, she was talking about some of the things that happened. Prudence, you may not want to tell. Frank Richard, or no, well, it wasn't Frank.
Was his name Frank?
It was Pete.
Mm-hmm.
But what is his
first name? His first name is Carl.
Carl, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Pete Richardson was telling Prudence what to do when she got into the schoolroom. And so Prudence, you ought to tell her what the school, there was our dear friend with Uncle Pete said.
Well, the first day we were out in the yard just playing, you know, kids were. So he went in and he says, now Prudence, when the teacher calls your name, he says, you get right up and salute her.
And the salute was a hand to the nose.
So I did. But the teacher said, you sit down, Prudence. Well, I was pretty embarrassed.
Oh.
Do you recall what the teacher's name was?
No, I can't. I can't remember. But one teacher we had when I was in lower grade was Wanda Sims.
Mm-hmm.
Now, she only taught, she didn't even teach there 1 year because she wasn't a satisfactory teacher and the board
had Now, that's
leave.
An interesting story. Do you know why?
Well,
what makes an unsatisfactory teacher?
She was really too young and she couldn't control the pupils.
Oh. I thought all students were just absolutely perfect back in those days, no? No?
I think they had some pranksters.
Yes.
They had to if they had told her if they told her how to salute the teacher.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, that's... And did you enjoy kindergarten after you got used to it?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, did they have a lot of toys and things to play with?
Yes, we had that peg game where you put the pegs in the board.
I remember that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And different games.
Toys. Then did the kindergarten have a kind of play area then?
No, it was all in one room.
But they didn't set you apart where you could kind of play the games by yourself?
We had a small little table where we could play.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I see. Uh-huh. And did they start to teach you reading that early or not?
In the kindergarten, we just learned more. Well, yes, you started right in the learning your ABCs and so
mm-hmm.
forth.
Mm-hmm. How many children were there? Do you remember in kindergarten?
Oh, my goodness, I think they see.
More than five?
Oh, goodness, I don't even think there was five. I can't remember just how many.
Small number, then.
Small number, very small number.
Mm-hmm. Did the older students help you sometimes?
No.
They didn't. Teacher had to do the whole thing.
Teacher done it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But you see, some grades, maybe there was only two pupils.
Oh. I can't imagine that. But was there ever a time when there were just two in your class?
You know, that's when I can't remember just how many there was in my class. Mm-hmm.
Probably changed though from year to year.
It would change. Mm-hmm. But you see, there wasn't too many people, really, that lived here around in this vicinity for the children to go to school.
Mm-hmm. What did the people mostly do?
They farmed then.
Okay. And lumber.
And then lumber.
Mm-hmm. Frank Richardson was a lumberman. Mm-hmm. I suppose he did some cattle and things, don't you?
I don't recall him ever having any cattle, but I know that he done a lumbering work.
Mm-hmm. Now, after they got said goodbye to Wanda Sims, the next teacher to come in, did she stay longer?
She finished that term. I don't remember then whether she taught the next year or not, mm-hmm. because Frances Wienes taught up here for several years. She taught up here.
Must have been here for years. Mm-hmm. In the book that you have there in 1920.
That's her name?
Mm-hmm. She was a teacher. But then that's skipping quite a bit now. Well, not mm-hmm. too many years, though.
And then Carrie McGillis. Well, then when she got married, it was Shirey. Mm-hmm. She taught school up here.
And did you have Frances Wienes? Did you have Frances Wienes sometimes, too, as your teacher?
She was there before Mrs. Shirey.
Oh,
Frances
I see.
Frances Wienes.
How mm-hmm. did you like her?
She was a good teacher.
Mm-hmm. You had her for first grade, then?
Well, I don't recall.
Oh, I see. First grade, second grade. Mm-hmm. Oh, I see. But it was got, at least you enjoyed the teacher,
yes.
whoever you
mm-hmm.
had for first grade.
Mm-hmm. Second Carrie grade. Carrie was a very good teacher.
Good.
Mm-hmm. What year did Miss Wienes come?
I don't know.
Well, it had to be, this was in 20, so Mrs. Shirey was there somewhere between 1914 in 1920,
wasn't she?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh,
because we only had school up here to the 8th grade.
Uh-huh. And the other one came later. Can you think of what was the most pleasurable part of the school for you? What did you like about it?
Well, I liked everything, and I especially liked May Day. Uh-huh. May Day is when we cleaned the yard.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, we would rake the leaves, uh-huh. and then we would gather mayflowers and make little bouquets.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Did you have a maypole dance to
No.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Did you clean up the yard? Mm-hmm. Did they give you little rakes and things to do it with? Or?
Well, no, we had regular rakes.
Regular rakes.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
I imagine we brought them from home, probably, uh-huh. you know, the rakes.
Mm-hmm. I guess it was nice to see spring, too, wasn't it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How did you get there in winter?
Walk.
Was it difficult?
Well, it was in the wintertime when the snow was deep, because they did not plow the roads then. Mm-hmm. So we had lots of snow to wait to get there.
And you brought your lunch with you, then?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, mother would tie a big
silk scarf over our face and, you know, over our nose and mouth. In the wintertime, because it'd be so cold, we'd have to face that north wind to mm-hmm. walk up to school. Mm-hmm. And the snow was so deep back then, you never even seen a fence post in the wintertime.
You think it was deeper then than now?
Oh, yes. We don't have the snow we had years and years ago.
Mm-mm. That's interesting. Mm-hmm. What about the summers? Do you think they're hotter now?
No, the summers was nice. Last May, it was always warm. Mm. Now our weather is very unpredictable.
Mm-hmm. One thing I was interested in, did they teach you to read by sounding out the words? Or did you just learn to look at them and see what they were?
We learned to look at the words.
Mm-hmm. You didn't have to say that C-A-T, the A is A-A-N and it's cat?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Had to do that. And so you'd know how, and if you put an E after it, then it would be Kate, or?
The first thing we had to learn was the ABCs, I can remember that.
They sing songs?
Yes, always in the morning.
Mm-hmm. Did your teacher always play the piano? Did you have piano?
We had no organ. Oh, yeah. Organ. Mm-hmm. But one song that we used to sing was Old Black Joe. And that song, oh my, you know, you never hear that anymore. But, you know, I had that record.
Do you really?
Uh-huh.
And the whole class would sing?
And the whole, everybody would sing in the school, the whole school. Mm-hmm.
Did you open your the mornings with the pledge to the flag?
Yes.
Always mm-hmm. open with the pledge. How about prayer? Did you say a prayer?
Yes, we had one teacher we had, we always said a prayer in the morning.
Do you think there should still be prayer?
I think so. I think there should be a prayer.
It helps you get started.
Mm-hmm.
And when you learned writing, did they teach you? I remember we learned it, Palmer system, where you had to do O's and O's.
Yes,
and
exactly.
Did you have that too?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah.
Must have been around the country pretty much. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's something they don't teach now, I don't think.
And I don't think they teach that now at all,
no,
do they?
No. Did you ever really write by that system, though, or did you go back to, or did you just eventually develop your own sort of hand?
Well, I really can't say.
Yeah. Okay, just write something for me.
I
mean, yeah.
And then you'll know.
Yeah, then I'll know if you're writing that Palmer system or not.
Okay, or whether I'm just doing my thing. Huh?
Yeah.
Well, you know, that's the way I learned, and I still write
the poem. Yeah, I think she's just in between, a happy, a medium, yeah. Partly this and partly this.
Yeah, she developed her own way.
That's beautiful writing.
Oh, my. Sometimes I can't hardly read my own writing.
Oh, that's lovely. Well, congratulations to whichever teacher it was. And did you have a lot of different books to read, or did you have mostly the standard readers?
We had our standard readers.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I wonder, did you have Dick and Jane?
Mm-hmm.
Dick and Jane.
Dick and Jane. Mm-hmm.
And then did the teacher read to you sometimes too?
Yes. Mm-hmm. They would always read a story to the whole, all the children in the school.
Mm-hmm. That must have been difficult to get one to keep the attention of the older ones and the younger ones.
Yes, you see, the teacher would read so many chapters, you know. Not very many, and then the next day you should continue.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
We have something to look forward to each day.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And in the wintertime we'd play games in the school. Bean bag, you know, throw the bean mm-hmm. bag and hit the circles. And,
mm-hmm.
Who would keep the fire going at the school?
The teacher.
Mm-hmm. Was that heated by wood then?
By wood. But you know, when I think now the hygiene that we have, and then we went to school as one teacher, you know, we've had this big wooden pot belly stove,
mm-hmm.
and that one teacher, I remember having a terrible cold, she was always blowing her nose, and she'd lay them pasties up on the top of that stove there to dry them, and I think now, look at all those germs going out through the room all the time. You know, wasn't that terrible?
Mm-hmm.
Why they wouldn't think of doing a thing like
that. Were you well most of the time?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, everybody was healthy, I think, in the back. You were out in the fresh air a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, you had the outside restroom.
Oh, yeah.
And then did you have a washroom?
We had just a pail set, and there was a basin, you know, on the stands in the floor. Mm-hmm.
Fun to think back, isn't it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What it's like. What were the kinds of clothes that you had then? Mostly, did you wear leggings or? Because girls didn't wear slacks, as I remember.
No, but we had leggings that you'd pull on. You know, but you'd take mm-hmm. them off when you got to school.
Mm-hmm.
And you'd have those little things that buttoned up the side. You know, you call them like a. Leggings, I guess they were called.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Long stockings.
Yes, mm-hmm. Long underwear.
Yeah, right.
Mm-hmm.
But then skirts.
We wore, mm-hmm. you know, wool skirts mm-hmm. in the wintertime. Mm-hmm.
Do you remember if there were more boys or girls in your school?
Oh, I would say probably maybe half and half.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
That 1920 book you have there of the school, that might give you an idea
how
many boys and how many girls.
I'm almost afraid to touch that.
It is so fragile.
Beautiful. Yes. Are there any particular students that you remember more than others, or you have a particular friends with?
Oh, I remember all of them in the school that I met there, because there were such a few of us, Dorothy and Bernice and Laura and Mary. And
they were all the rich girls, right?
We were all...
Look at that. Maybe you tell a little bit about them.
We were related.
Name the ones you were related to, Prudence.
The ones I was related to here at school, and that was, of course, my brother.
What was your brother's name?
Harry.
Where's your brother?
Harry Nolan.
Mm-hmm. And then there was Frank Richardson, Buster we all called him, and Laura Richardson, and Bernice Richardson, and Evelyn Theobald, and Geraldine Nolan.
These are all your relatives?
Yeah, I was related to all of these, yeah. Mm-hmm. The ones I wasn't related to, and that was John Pearsall, Burton Awesom, and James Gowdy, and Russell Awesom. But the rest, or Eileen Gowdy, but the rest we were all related in school.
Did that make a difference? Did you have a kind of clan group of the ones that were related and the others were outside? Or?
No. Mm-hmm. Everybody got along fine.
Mm-hmm. Weren't any fights then?
Well, I don't think there was. I can't remember. Probably there was a lot of them.
Minor ones, though.
Yeah. Probably. Mm-hmm.
Did you ever, as a group, go to visit another school or anything?
Not that I recall. Mm-mm. We had a spelling bee.
Oh, tell us about that.
Yeah.
Well, the spelling bees, you'd have to get up and spell and keep spelling until you would lose, and then whoever would be the winner that could do spell all the words and get them correct.
Mm-hmm. Were they pretty hard words?
Well, sometimes they were and sometimes they weren't. Mm-hmm.
And did you have the same school champion year after year?
No.
Did it change?
No, we didn't.
And it wasn't always an eighth grader that won?
No.
Mm-mm.
Do you happen to remember who was the youngest that ever won it?
No, I don't.
That would be interesting.
No, that's way back.
Can you remember what word put you down?
No, I can't even remember that.
I remember having one.
Which word put you down? I'm
curious. Well, I got to think about that.
All right.
I just can't do it.
Well, now, this is your tape, but I'm going to tell you a funny story. When I was in the spelling bee once, I went down on the word bigamy. And the teachers had a big discussion over whether that word should have been there. But should I have known how to spell it? That was a pretty good start. We won't put that in the paper.
You know what they used to do up here to raise money? They would have box socials, the adults. Mm-hmm. You know, you'd make a fancy box of different food, and you probably did too, did you?
No, we never had that. It's
well, you'd have a box, and you'd make nice different foods, fried chicken things, enough for two people. And you'd decorate your box all nice and pretty. And then they would auction them off. And whoever bought your box, that's who you had to eat, share your box with. Now the adults would do that to raise money for the school. Mm. And then sometimes they would have a shadow social. They'd hang a sheet up that light and then sell the shadow.
How cute.
Mm-hmm.
How would you do that? I don't even understand that.
Well, you'd have a light. And then you would stand, you know, where the light was shining, and there'd just be the shadow.
Or the shadow of the person.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
And
they'd sell that person's company then for the...
Well, they would just raise money by that, but then you would dance, you know.
They'd be a partner for the dance.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. play with them.
That's a cute idea.
They done that all up here to our school.
Oh.
We'd have those.
Did you dance in the school? Did they dance in the school?
Yes.
Yeah.
When they'd have those, you know, the adults, they'd all be there with their, for all those functions.
That was fun.
And then one time they had this colored man came too and put on a little minstrel show up here. And everybody came. He had to all donate a little money, of course, you know, for dance.
Who usually provided the music for the dances?
They, well, it would be people that lived in the neighborhood, they would just do it free.
Do they have a fiddler around
here?
They had
a fiddler and an organ.
Oh, mm-hmm. Good. Mm-hmm. I was wondering if you remembered any of the tunes that they played. Was it?
Well, I know one song that was Turkey in the Straw.
Oh.
Isn't that fun?
Did they have names for the dances, or are they just square dances?
Square dances, round dances, foxtrots.
Mm-hmm. So the foxtrots would have been in couples, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. And they'd have some square dances, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Were the children allowed to come to these?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. Always.
Always the children.
Always always there. You didn't have babysitters back then.
Right.
You know, you always took the children.
Right. What about learning science? Do you remember what kind of science you had and how soon you had it? Anything about that? Did they teach you chemistry? Did you learn chemistry?
Mm-hmm.
Or say biology? Anything about nature study?
I had biology and I went to high school, but not up here in the grade school.
In grade school, did they have nature study then?
Not too much.
You didn't study the trees or the plants or anything about those?
Mm-mm.
Did they ever talk about Higgins Lake? Did you ever discuss Higgins Lake or the lakes around here or how they could be preserved or anything like that? No.
No. Not that I can recall.
Did they teach any of the vocational arts? Did you learn sewing? Did they have a sewing class at all? Or cooking, no. You learned that at home.
See, it's in a very small school. You didn't have those things.
No, but you had thorough instruction in reading, that's for sure.
Reading, writing, and arithmetic, that was the main thing. And your geography.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, geography, right. How far did you go with the arithmetic? You had decimals, of course. Must have had, fractions.
Through the eighth grade.
Right, yeah. And geography, that must have been different. We had that rather differently, didn't we? Geography wasn't the same as it is now.
No. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. I wish I had my old geography book. I don't know what I'd done with it.
Yeah.
We learned so much from that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. History.
Mm-hmm.
History. The older ones.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All those dates you better memorize.
Oh, dear. Mm-hmm.
Well, that's something different, too. They don't teach dates so much anymore.
No, but they should.
Yeah.
I don't know why they don't, do you?
Children don't want to learn them.
Well, maybe that's it.
Mm-hmm. Well, maybe there are a lot more.
Well, there's so many things happening daily now that have to be stored in your brain. Or we could do look it up on a computer or whatever.
Yeah.
Just punch in what you want and there you are.
There it is, yeah.
Sounds like it's a lot easier, doesn't it?
But it isn't in the long run.
No.
They're not learning. Because it's just practice. They copy from that machine all the time to tell them. Well, years ago, we had to remember those things.
Did you have any tools to learn the multiplication table in the slide rule, or do you have anything?
Did you ever sing any of the things that you were learning? I know when my mother went to school, they used to sing the geography and sing the multiplication tables.
No, we never did.
We didn't. And one thing that I think is very interesting is the social interplay between the children. The little ones usually just play in a group, or else the girls play with the girls and the boys with the boys. But then there comes that day when they begin to get special friends. And I was wondering, how did they get together and decide, well, I'll carry your books home, or I'm interested in you, or...
That didn't take place up here in our school, no. Everybody played together. We'd play hide-and-go-seek. We'd play baseball out in the yard.
No boyfriend or girlfriend?
No, it was just... It was just there to learn, and that was it. And then it just, you know...
That's interesting, isn't it?
Yes. It's been really a wonderful talking.
Isn't it? Yes, I should say.
I thoroughly have enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm. Well, if my sister was here, she could tell you a lot more, probably, you know.
Why, did she go there?
My sister?
Yeah.
Grace.
Oh,
yes.
Grace, that was Grace.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
She taught school for years.
Where? In there, too? Richardson School too?
No, after, when she graduated and all, then she became a school teacher. She taught out here at Roscommon for several years after they moved back up here from Pontiac. Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
And she taught 1 year up here.
At the Richardson School?
Uh-huh. And then she taught over here at that Scott School, over here.
Now where was that?
Well, over here, you know, where the Baptist church is, down over the hill, that...
Oh, yes.
Grace taught there. Then she's taught up in El Dorado. And then they moved down to Pontiac. And she taught there at Lake Orin for, I don't know how many years she taught down until she came back up here. And then she taught out here.
So there was a lot of small schools, 1 through 8th grade, around this area.
Yes.
El Dorado. And
see, there's one over in Keno.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, the up here on...
Yes, that one over here.
Mm-hmm. It's the name of the road up here.
Oh, you can go over here. Gosh,
old 144.
Think. Yes, it was like off in the 144. Mm-hmm. Right on the corner.
And Avery Babcock's sister lived up there. What's her last name? She, oh, Avery's sister. Oh. She lived
Forrester.
Clara Forrester. Mm-hmm. That's the name of the road, isn't it? That goes
Forrester
up to,
Road, yes.
To the Scott School.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
And then just down the road here from you on Holly Road 603, and you find there was a school there at one time, wasn't there? That was probably way before your time.
It must have been.
I remember someone talking about going to school down there. Of course, then the main school in this area was the Richardson
mm-hmm.
School.
But you see, now the people that lived over here in Crawford County, they went over here to school.
Over to, on Forrester?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So it was sort of divided up
like
county.
It was divided, see. Mm-hmm.
Whatever county you lived in, or
mm-hmm.
township,
the township,
maybe.
The township.
Township.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why Keno had their own school.
Yes,
you know?
Because they had, you know, quite a few pupils over there. Mm-hmm.
Oh, they were township schools then.
Well,
each township had a school, or did they have more than one? Or?
Well, no, it couldn't have been that way, because you see, at that time, Richfield Township took in Keno. So I don't know just how they
divided
that.
It up.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
I don't know.
But the Richfield Township was a large township.
Mm-hmm.
And it extended way out here. And then
mm-hmm.
later on they reduced that. Now this is a Saville. But it was still Richfield when you were attending.
Yes, at Richfield that took in even St. Helens.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So they would have to have had a school in St. Helens. Then as they come out toward the Richardson School,
mm-hmm.
there was the Keno School.
Yes.
And then the Richardson School, that's about the only ones that right in this
mm-hmm.
area
right
then.
Mm-hmm.
But there was probably at least 3 schools in the Richfield.
Yes,
a
mm-hmm.
Richfield Township.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of people, really.
Yeah.
mm-hmm.
Had them all up, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. How many of the students are still in this, or stayed in this area? Do you know, of the ones you mentioned? the people here?
Well, I think they're about all passed away.
Yeah, but I mean, did they, while they were alive, did they...
No, my brother didn't. He went, when he got married, he lived in, he had lived in Lupton for a long time, and then he lived in Lansing. He left the... And I left here when I was only 15, went to Detroit, lived in my aunt, and got a job and went to work, so I didn't live back here again then, so in 59 when we moved back up here, after I was married. Now Laura stayed here all her time.
Richardson.
Yeah.
Bernice.
And Bernice. And Geraldine Nolan, my cousin, she didn't, she moved on. And Russell Austin moved on, and the Eileen Gowdy, she lived in West Branch and she got married. And Evelyn, my cousin, Theobald, she later on moved to St. Helens and she lived in Bay City. But practically, that was it. Well, Frank Richardson, he moved. Buster, he went down below.
It's interesting how many have come back, isn't it? They left, but then they've come back.
They came back, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because the tide right now, the population tide, is toward the north.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I guess originally there were more jobs in the south. More openings.
Well, right now there isn't too many.
No, not anywhere.
No, but you seem to have better employment in the north than we do down in the
south. Yes. Mm-hmm. Down south there isn't too many.
You know, somebody was telling me that there was a big to-do and a lot of trouble when they tried to consolidate the schools. Did you know anything about that or remember anything about that? They were sending the students all to one school, and the people that had them in the outlying districts were very upset about that.
No, I wasn't here when they were consolidating these schools.
In other words, when you graduated, it was still the Richardson School for the...
Yeah, I went to West Branch School, high school, for 2 years.
Uh-huh.
And then I went, as I say, down Detroit with my aunt and went to work.
Right.
I hated school, isn't it terrible?
And yet you have pleasant memories.
I have pleasant memories of it, but you know, I didn't like school. When I went to West Branch to school, and when I'd hear that bell ring in the morning of school, you know, I just got sick to my stomach. Now that's how much I despise school. No, but I just didn't like school.
Was it West Branch, the difference between West Branch and the school here? It upset you, maybe?
No, I guess it's because I just didn't like school.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But do you like it when you were at Richardson School?
Yes, I didn't like up here.
Well, you were one big family.
One family knew everybody.
Oh, well, there's the great key to it.
Mm-hmm.
Probably lonely when you went there to West Branch.
Well, probably. But I know the first 2 weeks I was so homesick.
Mm-hmm.
And after I got over that, you know, I never... Then when I went down to Detroit, I never got homesick. Never got one of them. I got that out of my system, I guess, when I first went to it.
Mm-hmm.
And then we went to the Catholic school in West Branch, and that was altogether different than a public school. So that made a lot of difference, too.
Mm-hmm. Was it stricter in a way?
Yes, mm-hmm.
And you didn't know any of the students there when you first went?
No.
Mm-hmm. That would be scary.
Mm-hmm. No, just Grace and I, we went down there and we didn't know any of the kids. The only ones we knew, and that was the Goodhart girls from Keno, and they went to the public school. Because the four of us lived together then, down there.
You had to go a long distance to go to a high school, didn't you?
And yeah, you didn't drive back and forth like you do now.
State.
You just went in state.
Like our girls do, or boys when they go to college.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's what we had to do then.
Mm-hmm. So, I know you've said this, but it's gone out of my head. With whom did you live then when you went to West Branch?
Oh, well, the Goodhart girls that lived over here in Keno, the Ovita and Thelma, and Grace and I. Our folks rented us a little apartment down there.
Oh.
And that was at age 15.
Didn't? That was 14.
14, and you had your own apartment.
Mm-hmm.
What trusting...
Well, the children then was different than they are today, you know.
That's fascinating.
You had your own Yes, that's very interesting, mm-hmm. Susan. Your own apartment at 14.
Yes.
To go to school
and
on
go
your
to school.
Own.
Mm-hmm.
You probably didn't miss anything.
Oh, no.
We went
to school. We knew we had to be in school.
Mm-hmm. Well, what did you do when you got sick?
If we got a cold, I think we just stayed home from school, the doctor herself. The folks would tell us, you know what? I think kids could take care of themselves more then than they do now, really.
And who cooked for you?
We done our own cooking week for girls.
Mm-hmm. How old were the others?
And well, let's see, Grace was 16, and Ovita was 17. And then Thelma was, I guess, around 15. But the folks could trust us. We never got in any trouble or anything.
Did the older ones kind of tell you what you could do and what you couldn't
do? No,
we
had done what you wanted to do, but you knew that you had to do things right. We'd get our schoolwork done, and then we would play cards in the evening, the four of us. We always played cards.
What kind of games did you play?
And we played Pedro. That's an old game, mm-hmm. you know. We used to play that a lot. And the kids would come over. We lived down here on the farm after going to school. Like, neighbor kids would come over and we'd play cards in the evening.
Do you ever play flinch?
No.
Mm-hmm. When did euchre come into the
I don't know. I didn't learn to play euchre until years ago.
Mm-hmm. Did you have a budget? Did your folks send you just so much and you had to make do on that?
Yes. Mm-hmm. They were sending so much to buy our groceries. Mm-hmm. Of course, we would take all of our things, like our potatoes and things like that. We took. They would come down about every other week, mm-hmm. our folks, and check and see everything was all right. And if my folks didn't come, the other girls' folks came down. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then, where did you mostly get your clothes? Did you go to a bigger town for them, or buy them locally? Or?
Well, the folks used to send away for them.
Oh, Sears Roebuck?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Everything was bought through Sears or Montgomery Ward, through mail. Mm-hmm.
Shoe size and all?
Everything.
Mm-hmm. Did you draw an outline of your foot?
Yes, and then stand there and measure your foot.
And then you sent that in, that was your shoe size. Mm-hmm. So. Yep, mm-hmm. I remember that.
Mm-hmm. There's something else I wanted to ask you about.
Did you sew, Putin?
Yes. Mm-hmm. I taught myself to sew. Mm-hmm.
Do you remember your first car?
Do first, I remember the first
the
car?
The first car you got?
Well, I didn't have that until after I was married.
Yeah. Well, I mean your family, but your family?
Oh, and the family had an old T model. Mm-hmm. And I don't remember when they got that.
That.
Mm-hmm. Is there a Nolan that's on the board of directors in that school there? Who is the board of directors?
Okay. Oh,
yeah,
I forget she can see us.
Yes, my uncle Herb Nolan. He was a moderator. And then my dad had a term at that too.
Mm-hmm. Name the directors there.
Ralph Hollowell. He was a director. The moderator was Herb Nolan. And the treasurer was Frank H. Richardson.
I don't understand what those particular people would have to do. What were their functions? The treasurer I can see, but did you have to pay money to go to the school? No,
no.
You didn't.
No. Uh-uh. The director and the moderator, they're the ones that discuss about the teachers, who they were going to hire. Mm-hmm.
And then the treasurer dispersed the funds. Then.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And they probably got made sure there was the fuel supply was there for the winter.
For the winter, the wood.
Mm-hmm. And the maintenance of the building.
Uh-huh.
Did they buy your books for you, or did you have to get those?
No, we had to buy our own books and paper and pencils, everything.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't furnished.
No. Mm-hmm. Well, I hope we haven't tired you out.
No, you haven't. No, not at all.
It's mm-hmm. just been delightful. You think of anything other to...
No.
I think we've pretty much covered the ground here.
Oh, it's been...